Hello students, my name is Professor Sonia Bajaj, Head of Department from Computer Science and Engineering Department, G.H. Raisoni University, Saikhera. In this module, we will discuss about motion control of motor using pulse width modulation. The pulse width modulation is a process in which duty cycle of constant frequency square wave is modulated to control power delivered to the load, that is the motor. It is a method of transmitting information on a series of pulses. The data that is being transmitted is encoded on the width of these pulses to control the amount of power being sent to a load. Examples of pulse width modulation could be found in various day-to-day devices like electric stoves, lamp dimmers, robotic servos, etc. Now, when we talk about pulse width modulation, then we also have to discuss a major aspect of pulse width modulation, that is duty cycle. As you can see in the figure, a duty cycle is the process of transmitting the data over the pulses. Therefore, when we talk about the technical language of duty cycle, then it could be given as something that you can see in the figure on the PPT. As you can see, there is a kind of square wave diagram in the PPT, which clearly depicts what is the definition of duty cycle. There are two parameters related to this duty cycle. The first one is T on, which is the on time, and the second one is capital T, which is the time period of the complete wave. The T on and T parameters are clearly shown on the figure. There are certain examples which are related to this duty cycle, wherein the signal remains on for some time and off for some time. The T on is equals to the time for which the output remains high, whereas the T off is equals to the time for which the output remains low. When the output is high, the voltage is 5 volts, and when the output is low, the voltage is 0 volts. You can clearly see this in the depicted figure. So now, from this T on and T off parameters, the total time period could be calculated as T on plus T off. The diagram of another example showing a duty cycle of 50% is as shown in the PPT. Now here, in this particular example, as you can see from the diagram, the T on, that is the time for which the output remains high, is 1, and the T off, that is the time for which the output remains low, is 7. So when we apply the duty cycle formula to it, which is duty cycle is equals to T on into 100 divided by T on plus T off, then we get the value for duty cycle is equals to 12.5%. Similarly, you can see another example wherein the T on has the value 6 and T off has the value 2, which delivers the duty cycle to be 75%. So, in order to study this PWM, that is pulse width modulation, duty cycle is one of the most important aspect which needs to be calculated properly. As we have seen it with the help of an example, in the first example the duty cycle is 50%, whereas in the second example the duty cycle is 75%. So after discussing about the definition of PWM and the process of duty cycle, now our third agenda for discussion in this module is the timers. when we talk about the timers in AVR, then first we need to discuss about what is the need of timers. Timers plays a very important role in PWM generation in Firebird 5. These timers are mainly used to provide a count on which the duty cycle wave is generated. In AVR microcontroller 2560 ATmega, there are two 8-bit timers, timer 0 and timer 2, and four 16-bit timers, that is timer 1, 3, 4 and 5. When the counter reaches its maximum count, it's rollover and executes from the start. For 8-bit counter, the rollover occurs at 255 count, and for 16-bit counter, it occurs at 65535 count. Now, let us have a discussion on the timers which are used for PWM generation in Firebird. Mostly, timer 5 is used for PWM generation for controlling the speed of the motors. The duty cycle of square wave generated by this timer 5 can be varied to produce different average DC values for the motors. Using a fast PWM mode can vary the speed of the motor. To program a PWM, first we need to initialize some registers before we can actually use it. So, our next agenda of discussion would be to study these registers in detail. There are total four registers, which are as follows. First one is TCCR5A, second one is TCCR5B, third one is TCNT5, and fourth one is OCR5N. Now, let us see each one of these in detail. First one is TCCR5A, that is the timer counter control register A. This timer counter control register A is used to configure timer for PMW generation. This is basically used to provide us the output in the form of waveform generation bit. Coming on to TCCR5B, this register is used to configure timer for PMW generation, but it's provide us with the clock generation bit. The third register is the TCNT5 register, which is used to count the up down according to the clock frequency. It is a 16-bit register and it counts from 0 to 255 when it is used in 8-bit mode. If TCNT5 is used in 16-bit mode, then it counts from 0 to 65535. Coming on to the last register, which is OCR5N. The OCR5N stands for Output Compare Register. It compares itself from TCNT counter and set the flags when the match occurs. In OCR5N, there are three 16-bit registers, which are named as A, B and C. These registers are used individually to generate PWM channel width. OCR5AL is connected to the left motor, whereas OCR5BL is connected to the right motor. Now, after having the discussion about PWM, its duty cycle process, the various timers that are involved in PWM generation, and the various registers that are required for this complete process, now we need to see how can we write a C program to implement this particular PWM modulation with the help of an experiment. Now, when in this module, we are going to perform a task which is aimed to get you familiar with the pulse width modulation. In this experiment, we will write a code to decelerate or to reduce the speed of the bot and indicate this on LCD. The program to perform this particular experiment is as follows. Firstly, we need to define the various header files. Here, the various header files included are avr/io.h, avr.interrupt.h, util/delay.h, and lcd.h. As discussed in the previous lectures, lcd.h file needs to be included whenever LCD is required to display any message on the screen. The very first part of this code starts with declaration of the global variables. When you declare any global variable, then firstly you need to provide a value to it. So here in this case, I have declared that variable as speed and have initialized it an integer value 0. Second is calling the function name. The function name is motion_pin_config. The input to this function is none and the output is none. Basically, this particular function is called to config the motion of the pin with your LCD. Now, the third part of the code is to initialize the desired I/O port using the I/O port registers. That is, we need to initialize the DDRX and the port RX to perform the further operation. So, we have written the next part of the code consists of calling a function which is motion_pin_config, and then we have declared the port A pin, that is PA3 to PO0, as the output port. Then the port A register is initialized with a value 0. Initially this particular register is given value 0 so that it can start its operation from fresh. Third thing which we need to initialize in this code is setting the PL3 and PL4 pins as output for PWM generation. Whatever PWM generation process will be done, that would be done through these PL3 and PL4 pins as output pins. And lastly, we have declared port L register to set the initial values of the port L pins PL3 and PL4. Then the next part of the code is to call function name lcd_port_config. Again, this is the code to initialize the I/O ports and I/O port register to call this particular function. As shown on the screen, here also the LCD pins are directed as output pins and all the LCD pins are set to logic 0. The third function which we will require in this particular experiment is for switches. So, a function named as switch_port_config has been called. Again, the I/O port and I/O port registers to call this particular functions have been initialized. Here we use pin 7 of port E to boot the switch and then we write a suitable value to pull up the pin 7 of port E. Then, after all the functions have been declared, the last part of this code is to initialize the ports which are used in this particular process. So, in order to initialize the port, we call a function called as port_init, and then in this particular function, in this particular code, we call all the three functions that have been declared or initialized earlier, that is the motion_pin_config function, the switch function and the LCD port function. So, this is how the coding in this particular experiment has been done with the help of LCD, switches and by configuring the motion pin of the motor. Now, after these functions have been declared, the last part is to set the timer so that the PWM mode for velocity control could be generated. So, in this particular phase, we will initialize timer 5, and under this timer 5, the various other timers like TCCR5B, TCNT5H, TCNT5L and OCR timers are given their values. All these particular timers have been set initially to start the timing function as the process gets commenced. Firstly, TCCR5B is set to 0x00 to stop the timer. And then, once the timer is stopped, in order to start this particular timer, a value of 0xFF is then sent. For the output comparison purpose, the OCR5AL and OCR5BL registers are used. Then lastly, for writing suitable value in these registers, TCCR5A and TCCR5B timers are set at equal values. Now lastly, we will see the function to control the robot velocity control. In order to call this particular function, basically two OCR registers are used, OCR5AL and OCR5BL. To set the motor's direction, in order to set the motor direction, we can call the functions forward, backward or stop respectively. The program to call or the procedure to write these particular functions has already been covered in the previous lectures. So, after initializing all the devices and calling the functions through the main program, we will finally get the output as shown in the video below.